Hi, hello. This is Ajit, and here I'm going to demonstrate you to register client machine under in SUSE Manager. So you can see in the first video that I have shown you that how to set up a SUSE Manager. So my name of machine is smgr.susamgr.com, which is as a SUSE Manager machine. So let's open the browser here. Great. So yes, so here we have currently we have one organization, which is the name of the organization is Software Solution. So that is also called top level organization. So the time when you are configuring a SUSE Manager, there is an option to set up a organization. So the first top organization that you create at the beginning of the installation is known as a top level organization. So organization is what? Let me show you something first. So here in SUSE Manager, you can see some set of options on the left hand side. This is related to some notifications, some user account, some your organization. Under in system, you can see the list of system. Yes, systems are there, system groups are there, bootstrapping is, you know, activation keys are there. So here we have a list of different options for a different purpose. So in case you want to see how many machines are registered under this organization, you can click here under system, all the system, then yeah. So there is no machine yet configured. There is no proxy yet configured under here inside SUSE Manager. No system group yet, because I have installed or configured this fresh SUSE Manager. Here we have a salt thing. So currently my master, this SUSE Manager working as a SUSE master as well. So that option will help you to execute command remotely. You can accept the key, reject the key. This is an image option which will help you to build an image to deploy to the kiosk machine, POS machines, right? You can build a machine, set up a profile, etc., etc. So yeah, we have a patching option here to patch. We have a software option here. You can see the list of different channels, SUSE channel, custom, clone. Yeah. So currently I have registered. I have three different channel. So channel is basically a collection of repository, and repository is a collection of packages. So I have subscribed these three channels. So SLE12, SP2, 3 and 4. If you want to see all the channels, you can click it here. So all the channel meaning is including SUSE channel and some custom and clone channel also. Right. If you want to create some custom channel or clone channel, I mean custom and clone somewhere same, right? But if you want to create your own channel, so you have to click here under in manage software selection, not software but overview, and down on the right hand side, you can see upside on the right hand, you can see create and clone option. So yeah, you can create some repository, custom repository. Like let's say you want to store some fail packages or some emergency channel that you wanted to create. So yeah, you have audit option. So with the help of audit, you can you know, cross check the number of machines, the client machines, right? You can cross check the subscription, whether they are being utilizing completely or not, right? So SUSE Manager basically sync their database with SEC, right? So SUSE Manager has information about the number of machines which are registered based on the database pushed by SEC, and SUSE Manager also has their Postgres SQL database. So so what SUSE Manager can do, SUSE Manager can check or cross check the number of subscriptions are being utilized, right? We have a configure option here. Configure option. We have a schedule option. So you can schedule something. You can see the number of failed jobs, pending jobs. You have a user option here. So you can create a user for any new organization, right? So when you click here, you can see active, deactivate, deactive user. Yes, here you can see the users basically. To create a user, you have to go to the edit admin option, I believe. I'm logging with the admin. Yes, I must have this all. There must be create. Yeah, that's here in the same box. Create user. So it's pure graphical. So graphical require a lot of things to remember. Command is a bit easier. Here you can see admin section where you can see the organization. If you have proxy in between SCC and you, then you can write proxy address here. You can see the number of product or entitlement you have set up is. You can see the mirror credentials, etc. So when you click here in this box, you can see. So sometime if you don't like to connect your SUSE manager directly to the SCC, then you can go through a proxy server, right? So you have to write this. I'm not going to click here in organization credential because here I have saved my mirror credentials related to my organization. So when you log on into the SCC account, you can see it may have that, like you can have multiple different organization under in the same SCC account, right? So different account, not account, but different organization will definitely have a different credentials to identify. So if you want to join a certain organization, then you have to write a certain credential here. Here I can show you the product that I have subscribed. In SCC channel, I have subscribed X amount of X number of you know things, but here you can see the total number of channels that I have subscribed it. So click on next. You can see, yeah, I have these three, right? Okay. Organization. If you want to create any, click on create organization. You can see the user here. So if in case you want to set up some kind of access control for the user, so you can click here, not here, on this side. I'm very weak in graphical, to be honest. Yes, this box. So you can check and check. That is, yeah. Okay. Admin. Help external. On this side, okay, on here, organization, sign out option, name of user you log in with, notification bar. So yes, my SUSE manager is currently working fine, right? It is a time to register machine under in SUSE manager. So if you see here, let me minimize it a bit. So here you can see I have one machine which is a build manager. So I would like to join this machine under in SUSE manager. Okay. So yeah. So let's connect with the build machine. Yeah. I have set up all those prerequisite. NTP is there, SSH is there, time zone. I mean, everything is already set up because I am running a SUSE manager already. And I'm not going to discuss those prerequisite now, partition and all. No. So let's check only the DNS one. Branch. Yes, I don't have to go to the branch, but build. Why this is going for branch? This is the build one, and I'm expecting this machine. So the name of machine is branch. Why it has to be built? hostname ctl set hyphen hostname build dot example.com, not example, susamgr.com. Susamgr, yes, and for this it should be, let me reboot it. Even it is not required, but meanwhile I can set up a name of different machines. So Linux, so the machine where I am currently working in 64 GB of RAM with Core i7, and yeah, so that's why I'm able to run multiple machines altogether. So that is branch one, which seems correct. Okay, so yes, root Red Hat. So let's check it again. Branch, how come? Sometimes some weird error makes all your logic fail. I mean, why this is going to take branch even the name of machine is properly set? I rebooted it and there is nothing like in, yes, I have set up my DNS correctly. Yes, and if I write build, it's returning the correct one. And let me reset again, set hyphen hostname build dot susamgr.com. Let's close it, open it, build. Anyways, let's go ahead. So what I can do, I can check SSH connection with these two, right? So when I write build, it should be IP 138, correct? And when I go for branch, it should be 139. BRANCH 139. Yeah, it's look good. Okay, so let's move back on my first machine, which is SUSE Manager. So yes, it is a time to join the machine between under in SUSE Manager. So here there are few steps that I'm supposed to follow in the correct order. So first is we need to have organization at least, and user also. That is your choice, of course, because the top level organization is already there. But if in case you want to create some more organization within the same SUSE, you can. That is one. Second is organization is more like a compartmentalized division of your company. Let's say you have your company related to many different nature of job. So what you can do, you can create a different organization, and the organization is a collection of multiple things. You can see I'm logged in with this organization, and under here I can see a different user. I can have a user box here, system box here, etc., images box here, patches, etc., etc., right? So we can have one top definitely and many different child organization or organization. And different organization may hold a different user with the different permission. So yes, we need to have a organization, right? Second thing is you have to have user which is already there. You have to create a group. It's a system group. So yes, you have to create a system group, right? So as the name says, it's a collection of system, right? So let's say I have a few machines related to development, I have a few machines related to retail kind of thing. So it is quite a bit easier for you to manage them if you have a group there. So system group need to be. Third is let's say channel you need to have, right? You know that SUSE channel is a channel where you are not supposed to, or you cannot even modify it, right? So if in case you want to do some kind of testing or maybe, so what you can do, you can clone them. So ultimately you have to have a channel. So channel is a collection of repos, and repos is a collection of packages, right? Okay. Then what next? Now we have a channel also, but we don't. Yeah, okay. So we need a registration key. So registration key is a collection of channel, package, organization, of course, registration. I'm very bad in typing. TRATIL, registration. So it's a collection of channel plus package plus organization plus system group. Meaning is when your client use this registration key, it automatically join a certain organization, it will automatically join a certain group, it will automatically authorize to sync with or download some packages because channel is attached to it with the registration key. You can add some custom packages if you want. Like I want this package need to be installed in certain, you know, things, then you can attach to it, right? What else? We'll see later. Okay, so this one registration key is needed. You have to create a boot script, right? Which will help you to to manage the registration process, the booting one, right? And you have to have repos for the channel, right? So generally, the repository is automatically created if you are using a SUSE channel. But for custom channel or some clone channel or some channel which is not directly delivered by SUSE has to have their own repository. So that is perfectly up to you. If you are using a same channel, there is nothing to create a repository because it is there already. Once you sync your SUSE manager with SEC, their channel and repositories get created automatically. Okay. Yeah, that's all I believe. So let's move on next and see how to do that. So for organization and user, I can see here I have an option called organization. So let's click on organization, make a organization SUSE. Name of user is, let's say it's me, and the password is fairly super complex. Okay, let's make it Ajit. So yes, organization is created, and under the user called Ajit, I can log on this through. Ajit, you can see. So I have a limited access. I mean, I am admin of that particular organization, but I'm not admin of the SUSE manager, right? So here we have at least a SUSE manager admin, meaning is the person who can manage the whole environment, the total number of organization. It's a super user of the SUSE manager type of that. And organization admin meaning is someone is admin, of course, but for organization only. So Ajit is a part of SUSE, so he's admin of that particular organization only. So based on the privilege you have, you can see the things, right? Just because of you are not a SUSE manager admin. If you are not a SUSE manager admin, you might not see all the option here. Like as I remember, there is maybe some options which are not reflected here because you are not a SUSE manager admin. Anyways, I'm not going to waste time moving ahead. Just close it, sign out, log on back to the same user. If in case you want to create some custom user, so you can click here. And yeah, one thing more, if you create a user here under in this account, this organization, then he will be a part of that organization by default. So let's say you want to create a user under in the SUSE organization, the different one. So you have to log in with the user, the admin of that organization. Then go here in admin section, then user, then not admin but user. So create here, let's say John, and the password is John, Mr. John, let's say Sukla. John Sukla, yes. And click on here, save it. Now I have to give some privilege. Currently you can see he's not a part of something, you see, he's just the plain user with no, I mean with limited access. But I want, you see, I have a choice here. I can make him as a SUSE manager admin where he has all access of this SUSE, and admin meaning just the admin user, right? So it look good. Okay, just update. System group, yes, he is not a part of system group and I don't want to add it here, right? So, and I cannot see any option here because you will be part of system group when you, when someone use the subscription. Anyways, we'll come down later. System, no system permissions. So what you can do, you can see these are the SUSE channel, right? Preferences, addresses, management. Anyways, we have a user ready here. What next? System group. So as I said, that system group will come under in system, then click on system. Here we have a system group. It's not here. Okay, system. So yes, so let's make it production. This is my testing. As I said, that system group is a collection of these things, right? So click on this, edit a group administrator. So John and Ajit is a part of that by default. Anything else I have to change it? Do you know, there is no system, no targeted system, patching is no, state, no. I'm not going to run any formula. Okay, so yeah, that's a system group. What next? Channel, right? Okay, channel. So the SUSE channel that you have synced first from SUSE to SCC, right? Those SUSE channel will be visible in all the organizations. So I created this organization, but when I go inside the software and SUSE, I can find those channels, which is fairly open for all the organization. So these are the SUSE channels. If in case you want to modify something, you cannot because it's not allowed. So it would be good sometime to create some clone channel on these, you know, the original one. So click on here, then organization, click on clone. Select the channel SP3. Yes, I'm using SP3 machine. My that client machine is SP3. Here we have option all patches, no patches, select patches. All patches meaning is it would have the base channel along with the child channel and the patches also, meaning is the basically the patches, right? No patches meaning is it would only have the base channel, right? not the patches one. So I'm going to select this one. So my purpose is, my intention is, I want to clone everything. That's why I'm going to choose this option. Click clone. Here you have to write the name of channel. So that is my production channel, which is easy to find. You can write some prod channel. There is no parent channel because I'm going to clone this, right? And that channel will be your one parent channel. So that's why we don't have any option here. Architecture fine, everything good. I have to write, why don't I copy this here? Okay, let's leave the summary as it is and then go for here. We have some choice. That thing will be available for all the organization, a specific organization, some kind of access control. That is fairly up to you if you want to set up trusted organization. And now I'm not going to set up it now. We'll discuss this later. Trusted organization will help you to share your resources among different organizations. So a channel from one organization can be accessed by other organization, but there are a lot of things which cannot share between organization, like system group, right, which you cannot see into other organization. But there are a lot of other things also which is not shareable. System can be, but not the system group. Okay, anyways, let's click on clone. And if you see here under in SUSE, this channel has some child channel inside, right? So I'm supposed to, I need to copy this, clone this child channel also. Go to the software management channel. I have my parent channel ready. Click on clone. Yes, clone from this one, because I have done this part. Go for manager tool. That manager tool basically hold some necessary package. The best one, the one is like salt minion basically, right? So I have to add this one. All patches is, the clone name is prod. Channel name cannot be a capital letter in the beginning. That's why I'm using a small p in the channel label. Parent, you see, now you have this parent created. So I don't need to take this parent, this as a parent, this one sp3, because I have my parent ready. Architecture, everything is good. Let's copy the same to save my time. Go down, clone. Follow the same process again. Manage repository, overview, sorry, clone, because there are two more child channel available. So clone. Prod. And the last one is, you can see, oh, why this two time? Something wrong, I did. Maybe I was in hurry, so I forgot. So I need to delete this, click it here, go down. There is delete option, no, on the right hand side, yes. So delete the channel. So how many now? What is not going to delete software channel? And that is a beauty of the you know, clone channel. You cannot delete the SUSE channel, right? And that is the prod of sleep, prod of prod. I think I did this twice, so I need to delete this one. That is the beauty of the custom channel. You have your control on your channel. So yes, my base one, the first one is ready. Go for this. I have to repeat the same step again. So I don't need to take this one. That is what I missed, that, Right. So clone from here. Right. That is a mistake I did. Because, yeah. So all clone. No. I have this channel ready and I have to clone the child channel of that remaining one. So click on here, then inside this. So I have to choose this, that is correct. All patches, yes. Then make it prod. Okay. Prod, great. And there's an option called parent channel. It is supposed to be here because I want to create this clone under this prod. So I think I did wrong somewhere. So manage channel. No, right here. Go delete. So we have a chance again to see the whole thing again, a whole thing back. Yes, there is no channel now. Click on clone. Yes, I want to clone this channel. All patches. Let's make it prod. Prod. There is no parent because it is itself a parent. Okay. Then. Yes. It is supposed to be here now. Yes, now go for clone channel. Which one you want to clone? I want to clone this channel. Make it prod. Command line option is much easier because see in a command line it is of course depend on the person to person. In a command line there is something called space CMD. Right, you can write a name of user here, then set a password. I think this one, yes. Here we have software clone list tree. List. I can see this here. If I want to clone it, I can simply run this create clone. Right. But when you go to the graphical one, you have to be very particular because you don't have a command access. You have to read the things properly. So yes, parent channel is automatically selected. I need to copy this here. Yes, and clone it. It is supposed to be under in the same. Yes, that is now good. Clone. Which one you want to clone now? I want to clone this update one. So we have a different channel. You see update one, tool one, and this one. Pool. Yeah. All. Just put it. Prod. Prod. Parent channel is the same one. So I have a two channel in. So go back, clone channel. So this one is last. Prod. Production. Actually, there's a live. When the update is released through SCC. we as a SUSE person, I mean, we as a admin of that organization, we do not patch the machine directly. We have some stages things in our organization. So when the patch is released, we put this into the development, then testing, then production, right? Here I'm much, I believe that my patches are good. There's nothing to test or something. That's why I'm going to make this prod kind of stages directly here. But in the real time, you always have some testing development in between the release of the patches. We don't blindly patch the machine when we test it first, whether this patch is compatible with your running application or not. Yes, so clone. Okay, so let's see. I'm expecting three channel inside. Yes, so channel is ready now. Registration key. So go to the registration. Remember, I'm logging with the Ajit user under in SUSE account. I'm not logging in the top organization, right? So for registration keys here somewhere. Yes, create a registration key. Write a name of key like SLI 12 SP3 machines, and here you can write SSLES 12, then SP3 machines. Yes, no space, Uses my base channel is you have created this prod one. Select this channel also, this child channel also. This is the base channel, child channel. Anything else if you need to add, you can. So click on activation key. As I said here, registration key is a collection of channel package organization system group. So there is nothing to change here. If I go to the package, I can write a package ABC DEF. Remember, here it is written that you have to write a package in a one line. Meaning is you cannot write two package by using a space or comma something, right? Configuration, no system, join it system group basically so that yes, I have one system group created production here. So click join so that your machine will all automatically be a part of this system group. So collection of channel package is there, organization is their system because it is under in this organization. So yes, it is the same. And channel is already there. So it is a collection of channel is there. If you want to add package, go to the package. Organization, yes, it is automatically set because you are working in this organization. So anything created under in this organization on by this organization only. And system group I created here. I mean, I joined here, right? So yes, it look good. Everything fine. What else? Boot script. So there are three different ways to join the machine into this SUSE manager. The one is there is a bootstrapping option where you can create a write a name of machine, blah blah blah, and click on bootstrap. It will automatically, everything will be set up directly. There is nothing like to create this script kind of thing. This one. So that is the easier one. Directly write it and click OK. The second method can be you need to create this script and push this script to the client, right? So I'm going to choose this one because this one is an easier one, the first one. So for that, you have to go to, there is an admin option. Under in admin, you can find the this key, right? And just because of I'm a part of organization only, So I don't find admin option here. Until I'm a part of system SUSE administrator, I cannot find this admin option here. So just log it out, go with the admin, click on sign in. There is an admin option you can see. And here we have, if I'm not wrong, yeah, Bootstrap. So you can see on the same time this location. Yes, so ls space srv www sta pub. Here we have a folder called Bootstrap, and there isn't one file only, right? Remember it, there isn't one file only. General, I don't have a proxy. This is my repository. Bootstrap file, yes, this is the location of my Bootstrap file which I will create later. This is the name of organization. Then we have a restart, we have something. So click on here, where here update option. I'm not going to change it. One more thing which is interesting, Bootstrap using Salt. So you can join a client machine either with traditional way where you don't need to use a Salt as an automation tool to join the machine. If you are using a Salt, then click it here. So if you don't want to use Salt to join the machine, click it, unlock and uncheck this option. So anyways, I am going to check it now. You can see there is a single file here. I didn't change anything here, right? Just click on update. And here you can see a file created. There are two files get created. Just enter. Yeah, bootstrap.sh. Right. So go to this file. This file. Even you can change the file name. That is perfectly up to you. I do some. So copy space bootstrap and then write something which is easy to identify. So I'm using slash 12 sp3. That's it. Maybe key. Go to this file, and there is a section called activation key. Right. So. Yeah, right here. You have to write a correct activation key, because activation key is a collection of organization, system group, etc., etc. Right. So if you are writing this activation key, that means when the client will use this activation key, he will be a part of that second organization, not this organization. Right? Because you might be getting confused here, ki we are logging with this user and organization, creating this key, that materially it will own this particular organization. Definitely not. The key which you are going to define will define the name of organization which the client will join it. So organization key is the most important, sorry, activation key is the most important. Right, so log out, log on with the Ajit, go to the system, then activation key. Here you can see. So yes. Save it. Right. Okay. I'm not going to describe all other options. There are many different options here, right? Fully update this box. Yes. So when you put yes, then it will be updated fully. Local repository one, which means it is not going to use the local repository available on the client machine. So if you want to use it, so we have a different option here. I'm not going to use it. So yes, I have my file ready. Next is repos for the channel. I have my channel created, but the repository is not yet created. If you go down here inside this, I'm expecting a repository for my clone channel, which is not by default here. So what I'm supposed to do, I need to run some command to create a, if I'm forgetting, then yes, this one, SUSE create bootstrap enter. So it asks you which repository, of which product repository you want to create. So here we have a 1, 2, 3. Select the correct number. I'm going for second. So press second, enter. And you know that I said that repository is a collection of what? Packages. Repository is a collection of packages, and you can see it is going to repository for the packages. Yeah, it is done. And here I can see I have my SLEETWELL, then that, then that, then that, and we have a packages here, right? So now we are almost completed the step. It is a time to join my client machine under in my SUSE manager. So I can let me see if anything. Yeah, that is cool. Just close it. Okay. I have to go to SRV, then www, then ST. Now pub, then bootstrap, and here I have a file. Now it is a time to join my client machine. So what I can do, as I said, I will use the pull method to join the client machine. So I'm going to cat this file, the file that I created, and doing some SSH root at build.susenger.com bin bash, enter. Yes, this look good. So far so good. Yes. Boot. Yeah, bootstrap is completed. So now I'm expecting the system has to be there inside my system box, this box, which is not currently visible, because as I remember that there is in one place where I'm supposed to. Yeah, that is the one. Until you accept this one, you cannot find the system visible here. So you have to accept the key. What I can do, if in case you don't want to, you know, do this manually, go to the salt master configuration file and write one keyword there, so that it will accept the key whenever it arrives. It is automatic way of accepting the key. So click on accept, go down here, there must be a system. Interesting. So it has to be, it is taking some time. Yes, it takes. Yeah, it is here. I can see. Yeah, it is. So your machine is joined, and it takes some time. I mean, depend on the patches, depend on the updates and all. And you can see the method that you use to register this machine. So your machine is successfully registered, and yeah, that it is. So the last command that I fire was you have to go to the location first. So cd space var www st docs, then bootstrap, I believe, and here I had a file. So cat space, you have to, if I'm not wrong, then that was the SLEETWELL sp3, something like that. Then you have to write sh space root at, what else, machine name susamgr.com bin bash. That is how I register, I push the command. And the last one was, I believe, to accept the key, go to the salt option and accept the key. If you are using the command line method, then you have to use a salt hyphen key space to reject R to accept A. Capital A for accepting all the key, small a for a certain key. So you have to write a key name here. So whatever the request come, maybe like ABC or something. So that is a way to. So that's all about registering machine under in the SUSE manager. So I believe that will be helpful, right? So I will come up with the second third video where I will help you to know how to set up a proxy server, right? So proxy is what, like if suppose you have your machine close to your SUSE manager, so there is no reason to create a proxy, right? But let's say you have an organization, some branch in the different location, so you cannot set up multiple SUSE manager there. So you can create, but yes, you can create a many different proxies. So proxy, as the name says, on behalf of, right? So proxy will download the patches into their cache. Proxy uses a SQL server there to cache the information and push this back to the client. So yes, we'll discuss this thing in the later video, the third video. Goodbye. Take care. Bye bye.